Students, we are going to see about the role of three groups in test planning and policy development. It has three parts: managers, developers, testers, and user clients. First one, developers. The role of developers working with management to develop testing and debugging policies and goals. After that, to keeping up to date with revisions and making suggestion to changes. Then each level of test then reflect the organizational testing goals and policies. So developer is a very important role. Then next one, user and client. User and client, it's a indirect role that also affect the organizational testing goals and policies. So we have to maintain the customer satisfactions. Customer satisfactions, reflect the organizational goals and policies. Successful organization means it is you need to customer satisfactions. Next one, upper management. Upper management roles to establish the test planning committee with funding to ensure the test policy statements and quality standards. Test policy statements contains the user input to the test planning process, after that acceptance testing and usability testing. Next one, to ensure the all projects and are in compliance with the test planning policies. Next one, to ensure the test log and incidents reports. Test log and incidents report means first one, test log. Test log, it means the organization to create the own format for test plan. We are using IEEE format also. Next one, test incident report. Test incident report means it is a problem report. A problem report means it is a unexpected failures. Then project manager supports the test planning maturity goals by preparing the test plans. Next one, summarize of critical group roles. Critical group roles, it has three. First one, manager. Next one, developer and tester. Then users and clients. First one, managers. Manager, it contains the task forces, policy standards, plannings, resource allocations. After that, supports for educational and trainings, interact with user clients. Next one, developer and testers. It contains the applying black box and white box methods. Then assist with test planning. After that, test at all levels and train and mentor. And after that, participate in test task forces. After that, interact with the users and clients. Then user client roles, it specify the requirements clearly. After that, supports with operational profiles. Then participate in usability testing and participate in acceptance testings. From manager to developer and testers, that is called test process. Then from developer and tester to user, we are using evaluations. Test process, then evaluation, we are going to achievement of DMM level 2. DMM level 2, after that we will proceed to DMM level 3 goals. Thank you.